morning and welcome to our meeting from Guadalupe Parish Community Meeting. Today's mass intentions are for Eterno del Descanso, for Guillermo Arenas, for the 50th birthday of Lydia Gabriela Martinez, and for the repose of the soul of Felipa. Please stand.
Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, the grace of the Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And
with
your spirit.
My brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mystery. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my heart and in my voice, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do. Through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary of God, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, the author of innocence and lover of chastity, who bestowed the grace of martyrdom on your handmaid, the Virgin Saint Maria Goretti, in her youth, grant we pray through her intercessions that you, as you gave her a crown for her steadfastness, so we too may be born in obeying your commandments. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. Genesis. In the course of the night, Jacob arose, took his two wives with the two maidservants and his 11 children, and crossed the ford of the Jabbok. After he had taken them across the stream and had brought over all his possessions, Jacob was left there alone. Then some man wrestled with me until the break of dawn. When the man saw that he did not prevail over him, he struck Jacob's hip and his supper, so that the hip socket was wrenched as they wrestled. The man said, "Let me go before it is daybreak." But Jacob said, "I will not let you go until you bless me." The man asked, "What is your name?" He answered, "Jacob." Then the man said, "You shall no longer be spoken as Jacob, but as Israel, because you have contended with the divine human beings and have prevailed." Jacob then asked him, "Do tell me your name, please." He answered, "Why should you want to know my name?" With that, he bade him farewell. Jacob named the place Peniel, "Because I have seen God face to face," he said. "Yet my life has been spared." At sunrise, as he left Peniel, Jacob lived alone because of his hip. That is why, to this day, the children of Israel do not eat the sciatic muscle that is on the hip socket, inasmuch as Jacob's hip socket was struck at the sciatic muscle. The word of the Lord.
Thank you,
In justice, I shall behold your face, O Lord. In justice, I shall behold your face, O Lord. Hear, O Lord, a just suit. Attend to my outcry. Hearken to my prayer from lips without deceit. In justice, I shall behold your face, O Lord. From you let my judgment come. Your eyes behold what is right. Though you test my heart, searching me into the night. Though you try me with the fire, you shall find no malice in me. In justice, I shall behold your face, O Lord. I call upon you, for you answer me, O God. Incline your ear to me, hear my word. Show your wondrous mercies, O Savior of those who flee from their foes. In justice, I shall behold your face, O Lord. Hide me in the shadow of your wings. I, in justice, shall behold your face. On waking, I shall be content in your presence. In justice, I shall behold your face, O Lord. Please stand. Alleluia, alleluia.
Alleluia, alleluia.
I am the good shepherd, says the Lord. I know my sheep, and mine know me. Alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
At the morning, a demonic who could not see was brought to Jesus, and when the demon was driven out, the mute man spoke. The crowds were amazed and said, "Nothing like this has ever been seen in Israel." But the Pharisees said, "He drives out demons by the prince of demons." Jesus went around to all the towns and the villages, teaching in the synagogues, proclaiming the gospel of the kingdom, and curing every disease and illness. And the sight of the crowd, his heart was moved with pity for them, because they were troubled and abandoned, like sheep without a shepherd. Then he said to his disciples, "The harvest is abundant, but the laborers are few. So ask the master of the harvest to send out the laborers for his harvest." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Today, in the first week, we have Jacob, his famous wrestling with the divine. Jacob does not know whom he is wrestling. And the divine pretends that he does not know Jacob. But the divine knows Jacob very well, and as we see, he later on changes the name of Jacob to Israel. Now this was a common thing that they did when anyone had their lifestyle changed, or their life, things that they did were different from before. Yes, their names were changed. And we see that in the Bible history, both in the Old Testament as well as in the New Testament. It is something that is very important to change that. Now there's a wrestling match that is there between Jacob and the divine. It shows us that we also can have an encounter with the divine. This encounter that is with the divine is supposed to be the real one. As we see Jacob, his fight with the Lord was real. He asked the question, "Who are you?" And the divine does not answer, but instead he questions him. And yes, Jacob now, when he is having this, it shows that there is a sort of an intimacy between Jacob and the Sacred One. That intimacy that is there, it shows that there is something growing in them. So much so that Jacob is so assertive. He tells the Divine what he wants and needs. And yes, on the other side, we see God is not just the one who thinks about being far away from it. He is involved in the human nature. He is one with the human nature. And so he becomes like, and not something that is transcendent of knowing God, but it is something that is actually happening, of meeting and encountering God, where there is an interaction and there is also an exchange of things that are happening. That is exactly what the Lord wants from us. We need to exchange our life with the Lord. And if God will interchange with us, He will talk to us. We listen to Him. And we go on to do even questions that Jacob has questioned. It is that intimacy that we need with the Lord. And this is possible because we see it has happened in Jacob and the Divine. If it has happened to him, it can happen to us. We also can have that intimacy. Yes, we may not find the wrestle like Jacob did, but yes, in our minds and hearts, sometimes we do question. We do have a problem. We do say things to the Lord. The Lord listens. He understands. He is one with us. And as He listens and understands, He also shows us the way. He listens to you. And when we have understood Him and listened to Him and act upon Him, then you see a life that is really very good with the Lord. That intimacy helps us a great deal. Today we come to this altar to pray that we have an intimate relationship with God. In gratitude for what has been before, for what will be, let us offer our prayers to the God high in joy.
For the church, through its ministry, people may experience the healing power of Christ in their lives. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, we have a
prayer. For Pope Francis, Archbishop Gomez, our regional bishop, David O'Connell, and the bishops, priests, and deacons of our church, that their ministries be touched to people this earth with compassion and understanding. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the nations and peoples of the world, that they may recognize, respect, and affirm the dignity of every person made in the very image of God. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That God will turn our hearts to all the suffering people in the world, especially those who are helped by the Peter Spence Collection. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the members of this community, that we may be aware of the power we have to be to heal through a kind word or a thoughtful deed. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the dead, especially those who are dear to us, that our Lord may awaken them to eternal glory. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That God may hear the intentions of our faith community of our native Guadalupe, and the prayers we now make in the silence of our hearts. And may these prayers be granted in accordance with the will of God. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Heavenly Father, you sent your Son into the world to heal our wounds of body, mind, and spirit. Help us to have complete faith in His healing power and in your love for us. We ask this through the same Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you,
fruit of the work of human hands, it will become the bread of the Lord.
Blessed be God forever.
By the mystery of this water and wine, may we come to share in the divinity of Christ, who humbled himself to share in our humanity. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have this wine to offer, the fruit of the wine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual bread.
Blessed be God forever.
With humble spirit and contrite heart, may we be accepted by you, O Lord, and may our sacrifice in your sightest way be pleasing to you, Lord God. Wash me, O Lord, from my iniquities, and cleanse me from my sins. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice of my sins with the grace of your mercy, for the good of all his church.
May this offering be bring in celebration of the Blessed Mary of the Bed. With your gracious acceptance, O Lord, we pray, just that the struggle of the suffering and passion was pleasing to you through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you.
And in your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation. Always and everywhere, to give you thanks to the Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For the blood of your blessed Mother Maria the Virgin, poured out like Christ to glorify your name, so spoke your marvelous words, by which in our weakness you perfected your power, and on the feeble bestowed strength to bear you witness to Christ our Lord. And so with the powers of heaven, we worship you constantly on earth, and before your majesty, without end, we acclaim,
Holy, Holy, Holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, this gift we pray, by sending down the Spirit upon them, like the new fall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and giving thanks, he broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to the disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in
The mystery of faith. When we eat the bread and drink the cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of your death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread for the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, Jose Gomez our Bishop, and all the assistant bishops and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the life of your have mercy on us, all we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the Blessed Joseph, her spouse, and the Blessed Apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may meditate your heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the serious command informed by the divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our day, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin, safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, peace I leave, my peace I give. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you all.
And in your spirit.
Let us offer each other a sign of peace.
Lamb of God, who takes away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, who takes away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, who takes away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
May the receiving of your body and blood of Jesus Christ not bring you to judgment or condemnation, but through your love and mercy, be for me protection in mind and body and spirit. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
May the body of Christ keep you safe for judgment.
Amen.
blessed. Lord, you're 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 blessed.
Let us pray. O God, who bestowed on the Blessed Maria the Virgin a crown among the saints for her twofold crime of virginity and martyrdom, grant me, pray, through the power of this sacrament that greatly overcome every evil, we may gain the glory of heaven through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
And you have a wonderful day.